Welcome. I'm just getting my notes all situated here. I realized I didn't have them out. Welcome. My name is Carrie Lewis Newton. I'm so glad that you're here this morning. I would bet that a good majority of you are watching this on the replay, which is fabulous. You want to make sure that you have a notebook out and a pen to help you kind of stay focused and get all the points down. I'm really excited that you're here. And I'm just going to wait just a second to let some people hop on. But just if you're tuning in, my name is Carrie Lewis Newton. I am a top leader in the network marketing industry. I'm a top leader with my company. My passion is to train women so that they can fulfill the purposes that they have for their life. And I definitely feel that that's what I'm doing with my life. I didn't know until about 3 years ago what exactly I was called to do, what my purpose was, outside of being a mom and a wife, and I have definitely found that in the industry that I'm in. This is going to be an industry-wide training. It's not going to be hard to figure out which company I'm with. You can definitely go follow me on my personal page, Carrie Lewis Newton, or even on my product page, KLN Beauty. But this is kind of a generic page just for training in the network marketing industry. My belief is that if we all do better, then we all do better. When we aren't doing well, none of us do well, or only a few of us do well, right? And I think the topic of virtual parties, man, if we all do better, then we will all do better. Because this topic, when done incorrectly, when done in a way that does not make people feel good, it can give the entire industry a stigma. And so I'm really passionate about getting rid of that stigma. And I think this particular area is one of the areas that we haven't done a great job in. And so here we are, okay? All right, I'm glad you're on here. Again, my name is Carrie Lewis Newton. I'm a top leader in this industry. I am the team leader of Team Flourish. This training is for them, obviously, but I'm opening it up industry-wide. And if you are on Team Flourish, give me some love. Let me know you're here. Hashtag Team Flourish in the comments so I can see my people. This has been a long-awaited training. I have been asked about this topic over and over and over again. So why? Why am I asked about this topic? Well, for those of you that don't know or don't know kind of my story, I started in direct sales about 2.5 years ago. I joined my company because I wanted the products. I wanted to look pretty. I had no intentions of selling. I got bit by the bug very early on, realized that I could make some money from home from my cell phone. And the way that I learned to do this, the way that I taught myself to do it, it was through the virtual party experience. Now, the company that I'm with is the inventor of the virtual parties. We are the first ones to have done a virtual party. So we're kind of the pioneers. I knew right away that I could make this work, that if I could figure out a way to make money while being at home, while on my phone, I could change my family's lives. I knew that I didn't have the time to leave my house. I knew that I couldn't be gone in the evenings to run parties and that I had to figure out a way to do this from home. And so that is what I immersed myself into, was becoming an expert in virtual parties. So, what has made me an expert? I don't like to talk numbers. I firmly believe that numbers should be used to inspire and to give credibility. Never to boast, never to make yourself just shine above others. I really believe that numbers should only be used to inspire someone else and to give credibility for what you're about to talk about. So I just want to give you some quick numbers just so that you say, okay, maybe I'll listen for just a minute, okay? In 2.5 years, I have run 1,026 online virtual parties. In 2016, I took the award for top sales through virtual parties in the company that created virtual parties. So, it kind of makes me a little bit of an expert, just because there aren't a ton of people that have done that. You also need to know this. I have run, on average, 33 parties per month since I joined my company, which means that I have started a virtual party, more than one virtual party every day since I joined my company. It makes me tired just saying it, okay? You also need to know this. Out of those 1,026 26 parties that I have started, 551 of them have qualified. So what does that mean? Half, less than half, because that accumulates, that accounts for some of my own personal parties. Less than half of my parties have qualified. In our company, that means $200 in sales. Less than half. So you want to tell me about not having a qualified party? You want to tell me about it not working? You come talk to me when you've had over 500 unqualified parties. Because you see, I may be the number one in sales through qualified parties, but I guarantee you, I would love for corporate to back this up for me, but I guarantee you that I am also number one in unqualified parties. Okay? You ready to listen? All right, let's get started. What I learned very quickly about virtual parties is that it's not about the sale. It's not about the sale. In fact, nothing I do in my business is about the sale. It's network marketing. Everything has to be about expanding that network. And this is the way that I have found to expand my network to create a following that trusts me. Okay? Parties are planting the seed. Okay? That is the way that you gain interest. That is the way that you get people to stop, take notice of you, and begin to start a relationship with you. That is how you gain friends on Facebook. It is planting the seed. Now, the icing on the cake is obviously getting some sales and getting some rewards for those toastuses. But it ain't gonna happen every time. That's life. It ain't gonna happen every time. But every single time that you have an online party, you can expand your network. That is an awesome thing. That is where you find success, okay? Not about the sale, it's about planting the seed. And then those people are gonna watch you on your Facebook personal wall. That's gonna be watering that seed, okay? They will become your friend through the online party. They find interest in you through the online party. They watch you on your personal wall where you water that relationship, you begin to let it grow, you add them to your VIP or your customer group, and that relationship begins to form. And someone that you met in a virtual party 6 months ago may eventually decide to buy from you 6 months later, and you may have never actually had a conversation with that person. Start viewing them like this and stop getting so bogged down with the sale. Okay? All right. But that's not why you're here. I know why you're all here. That's not why you're here. You're not here for me to tell you why they're important, even though I think there is nothing better that I could tell you or that I could help you with than to switch your mindset of to what the purpose of an online party is. And you have to understand that my success in this area is not my script. It is not my personality. It is not because I'm good at building relationship. It is because of my mindset. And my mindset has always been, how can I expand my network? And I don't care about failure, because every failure gets me to my next success. Every unqualified party gets me to my next person that's gonna blow up my network. Okay? Got it? All right. But that's not why you're here. I know why you're here. So what happened, right? What happened, Kara? You've been keeping this from us for 2 years. Well, not true. About a year after I joined my company, I was asked to speak at our national convention on the topic of virtual parties. It blew up. It blew up. Why did it blow up? Because everyone just loved me so much? No. I'm not naive enough to think that it's because everyone wanted to be my friend, or because they thought I was cute, or they just liked the way I talk. That's not why that convention class blew up. It blew up because I gave you tangible information, tangible advice on how to run a virtual party. That's why it blew up. And that's something we're missing in this industry. We are missing tangible, actual, this is what I do advice to advance in our business. We have a lot of high level trainings and very few trainings that actually say do this. And that's why it went well. That is why my inbox blew up to over 1,000 messages in one day. But what happened was my life got crazy. People started doing insane things to try and get my party script, and I shut it down. And this last week while I was out at my corporate offices, I was asked, what is one thing that we could change in the training? And it was like I had a come to Jesus moment, and I realized one thing we need to change is our ability to believe that there is enough success for everyone. And the reason I think that we lack a lot in tangible, actual, do this is how I found success trainings, is because deep down we don't believe that. We don't believe that there's enough success for anyone, for everyone. And I think there was a little part of me that thought that too. And so if I'm going to practice what I preach, then I'm going to believe that there is enough success for me and there is enough success for you. And it's okay if I share with you some of the specifics that have gotten me to where I am. So are we good with that? I'm going to share with you some of the specifics. Okay. So I think this will work with any company. So it doesn't have to be my company. I'm going to be using examples from my company, but I definitely think that this will work with any direct sales company that you're with, okay? And I'm going to use some examples of some other products besides mine. Just so you know, I do a 5-day online virtual party. I do not call them parties. For me, I call them classes. This is another mind shift change that you have to have. You have to believe that what you have is valuable and worth offering. Did you notice I said offering and not asking? You are offering someone something. I never ever go into a conversation with someone about one of my classes thinking that they are doing me a favor. No, no. I put a lot of time and work and effort into this. I am the one offering something. And so that is a mind shift change you have to believe about yourself, okay? That you are offering something. You are offering something. This is not asking for favors. This is not asking for favors. You are giving them an experience where they are going to walk away with something. Okay? Believe that and then go offer it. Don't ask. All right. 5 days. I do 5 days. I believe any longer than 5 days, you're going to lose people. And with Facebook algorithms, it tends to kind of drag on. You don't get as many views. So I'm doing 5 days. Okay? I also, this is the a way you have to look at the virtual party in whatever company you are with. How is this party, how is this experience, how is this class going to solve problems? Okay? So it's not about sharing techniques. It's not about sharing the product. It's not about sharing looks. It's about solving problems. And so whatever your company with, your product can solve a problem. You have to figure out what those problems are. Because if you can solve someone's problem, they will buy whatever it is you have, okay? So first, you want to make sure that you get them with a welcome, all right? Now, I know you are all thinking, are you using groups? Are you using events? Are you using a 30-minute? I don't care what you use. Okay, I don't care if you use groups, events. I don't care if you do this in 30 minutes, 3 days. I don't care if you do this live. Okay, these ideas you can fit into whatever type of virtual party experience class you want to do. Okay, but it is really important that you get a welcome in there. All right, so that's the first thing that's always there waiting for my attendees, is a welcome video from me. It's usually about a minute long, just letting them know, hey, you're part of this class. We're gonna be learning about makeup application techniques. You're gonna grow in confidence. I promise this is not gonna be annoying. This is gonna be a fun, upbeat, okay? You get what I'm saying? It's about a minute long. I don't want to hear about your kids. I don't want to hear about your company. I don't want to hear about, you know, why you joined. None of that. They don't care, okay? The goal of this video is to pull them in, all right? Pull them in. Give them a reason to want to stay. We still here? Had a phone call coming in. Give them a reason to want to stay in this party, okay? Anything over a minute is going to say to them, I'm not watching anymore, all right? So that's your welcome video. That's already there before they even get in the group. Then after some people are there, you're going to just do a post. My post usually is a picture of me. It's one that catches their attention, okay? It just tells them a little bit about me, a little bit about me, a little bit about the company that I represent and what they can expect for the next week. And if they want to order, where the link is for them to order, okay? And then finally, that evening of your first day, okay? That evening of your first day, that is going to be a video that speaks to the masses. Okay, that's going to be a video that speaks to the masses. So in my industry, in my opinion, something that all women want to know more about and most don't have a clue is eyeshadow application. And so I do a video that evening on eyeshadow application because that pulls the most amount of people in, all right? That is the one that they are, most women have the most trouble with, that don't feel very confident in application. And so I give them a very simple way to do eyeshadow. Now, if you're not with my company, what about a cleaning company? Well, for me and most women, I think we hate just an example, I hate bathrooms. So that's where I would start. Start where the masses are, okay? If it's an organizational company, you know, I have a terrible time with my kitchen pantry. So start with kitchen pantry. If you are health and wellness, you know, start with, I cannot figure out how to make a healthy lunch. You get what I'm saying. Start with the masses. Where is the biggest, where are you going to hit the most people? Okay. So for me, it's eyeshadow application. All right. That's your first day. Day two. I move on to just face, okay? Now, this is key. This is key. You do not want to start with products that you need trust and relationship to buy, okay? So, for me, in what I'm doing, skincare is a product that you need trust and relationship to buy. I'm never going to post about skincare in a virtual party because they don't know who I am, they don't trust me yet, and they're not going to buy that from someone that they don't know. That takes time, okay? Now, I will post a picture of myself in a mask, okay? And that's the first post on that day just to let them know that skincare is important for makeup application, okay? It's also important not to start with your most expensive product. All right. You don't want to start. Don't want to go out the gate with the most expensive thing in your website. All right. So I don't spend time on products that you need trust and longevity to buy. That's for later. That they can get on my wall. That they can get in my customer group after we've created a relationship. But I do want them to know that it's important. Okay. So I start with my mask on day two, post one, just letting them know that skincare is important, teaching them that the best makeup application happens on healthy skin, all right? Then I also want to let them know where I used to be, okay? So I do a before and after. I show them what my skin used to look like, and then I show them what it looks like now. That creates trust too, and it's a little bit of vulnerability. I'm showing them a picture of my face with a lot of acne. I'm showing them a picture of a time in my life where I didn't have a lot of self-esteem, and I talk about that. Because if you followed me for any length of time, you know that one of the most important things that you can do in social media is show people your weakness, because people connect with you in weakness. They'll admire you for your strengths, but they will connect with you in your weakness. And so I make sure that they see that vulnerable part of me that has the bad skin and the acne, and then what it looks like now, okay? After that, I do a post about color matching. It's a problem. Women have a really hard time picking the right color for their skin. And so I just do a really quick post on how you can tell what is the right color for your skin. All right. So that's post three on day two. And then the final post on day two, the problem, okay, because remember, every day we're solving a problem. The problem we are going to solve is with foundation. So I want you to sit down and tell me, what are the things that frustrated you or frustrate you about the product, okay? And it may not be foundation. It may be cleansers. It may be candles. What frustrates you about candles? It may be jewelry. What frustrates you about jewelry? Figure out a problem that you can solve that you once had. So for me, in foundation, I had a very hard time not finding a foundation that didn't get cakey on my face, that was the correct type for my skin, and that didn't look too heavy, but I still needed coverage. These are all problems that every woman has, right? I solve that problem in my video. I show her how my product doesn't go on cakey, is perfect for my skin type, it's not too thick, it still covers the areas, but I'm not going at it from a look at this product, I'm going at it from the angle, here's the problem I'm solving for you, okay? So that's post four on day two. It is a video solving the foundation problem, okay? All right, that's day two. Let's move on to day three. Day three, all about the eyes, right? This is one that every woman is interested in. We all have eyes, right? We all have eyes. I start out with the trend right now. The trend is eyebrows. And I talk about the fact that You know, I'm a child of the 90s. My eyebrows need help. I explain why eyebrows are important. A lot of women don't even know why eyebrows are important, that they create a more youthful appearance, that they thin when we age. And so it's, you know, a surefire way to tell how old someone is by how thin their eyebrows are. Okay. And so the very first problem that I address is we got to fix these eyebrows, right? And I do a video on eyebrow application. And another problem we have, and this is post two, cream shadows, right? Cream shadows. And again, this would work with any company. Just go through your products. What are some problems you had before you started using your products? How did your products solve that problem? For me, I hated cream shadows, as a majority of the women do, because cream shadows crease. So I'm going to solve that problem for them with my product. Now, my next video actually has no words whatsoever. I do a video on our splurge cream shadows, and it's just me applying them, showing them different colors, no words. It's just music sped up. So don't make this complicated. It doesn't have to be explaining everything. You can show them a lot without ever having to say anything. All right. So on day three, we're solving the problem with eyebrows, cream shadows that crease, finding the perfect mascara, right? So every woman, I don't care who she is, she has searched her entire life for the perfect mascara. And I just jokingly address that, okay? That we are looking for the perfect mascara. And I just show a banging lash pick, all right, with the mascara. And again, with other products, you know, it can be a simple everyday pair of earrings. What is the perfect pair of earrings that every woman's been looking for her whole life? So you see how you can incorporate this into other brands, other products as well. And then finally on day three, my ending problem solving video is on eyeliner and mascara and the fact that most women will find by the end of the day that they have makeup under their eyes because it has run throughout the day. And I'm now going to solve their problem and show them how these products are not going to run or smear under their eyes. Okay? That's day three. Now, a lot of times before day three and day four, I go live on my wall. I make sure that I message every single one of my hostesses. I let her know that I'm going to be giving her a special shout out, and I ask her to share my video to her wall. Okay? That is how I personally incorporate lives into my parties. Now, you can absolutely, sorry, I have someone texting me. You can absolutely share these into your parties. Go for it. I personally have too many going at one time that I can't do that. So I have had to kind of figure it out, work around that, and I have my hostesses share it to their wall, okay? It's another way for me to connect with my hostesses during that week too, just to make sure that they're enjoying it, that they're learning something, okay? Then we're moving on to day four. I do lips, okay? I think a lot of women have an idea of what they love in lipstick, and a lot of women don't have a clue, okay? Address that. I let them know. There is a range from a chapstick-like lip product to an actual lip stain. Let's figure out where you fall in the middle. And so I talk about, what is your lip commitment? What do you want to be? Are you the chapstick girl or are you the lip stain girl? And I show them different pictures of each one, okay? One of the biggest problems, I mean the problem with lips, are lips that last. And so I focus on lip stain. My next post is on lip stain. And another video where there's no talking. I just show them a slew of things that I'm doing with my lip stain on, and it's not coming off. Drinking coffee, kissing my child, putting on chapstick, so that they can just see this is the problem. Our lips come off when we drink coffee, when we kiss our kids, and when I do show you this, this product doesn't do that, and I've just solved your problem, okay? Another thing with lips, women don't have confidence to wear lips. They don't. So I talk about that. I made a post about how red lips are a big deal, and the next time you see a woman in red lips, compliment her, because she's a confident woman who made a decision to walk out of her house with red lips on, okay? And then finally, my last problem solver of the day for lips is the whole debate between neutral lips and bold lips. And I think that's a big one. That's a big problem solver. Are you a neutral lip girl or are you a bold lip girl? And if you're one or the other, how do you go about transitioning into the other? And so I give them just the perfect neutral lip. I give them a great bold lip that anyone can try. It's a great first timer bold lip, right? And that's my problem solving video for the lips night. And that's the end of day four. Day five is the last day of class, okay? I start with a video that is the problem that every female has. She does not have enough time. And so I show her a quick 5-minute face. This is a great way to show them that this is a problem that can be solved, okay? And I think with any company, with any product, you have to address the issue of time, but I don't have time. How is your product going to solve that problem for her, okay? And so that's what I do on day five, is I show her how we can solve the problem of her not having enough time, all right? I show a collage of just the different looks that I do. It's a call to action. It's a call for women to be creative, to be confident, to wear different looks, to not get stuck in a rut, okay? Also, the third post is just a reminder that the class is ending. Class is ending today, okay? And then finally, the very last post of the day five is a thank you and just a letting them know why I do it, and that the reality is I believe that a beautiful woman is a confident woman, and so the goal is confidence, and the beauty will come from that, and that I believe that just a little bit of something to the outside can help her in that confidence. And so that's the end of the class. That's the end of day five. They get that video. Day six, I do still post, okay? So day six is just a thank you to the hostess. I let her just everyone know how awesome she is, okay? I let everyone know that the link is going to be open for another 5 days. They still have time to order, all right? My next post is the post that they need to follow me. If you liked me, if you were inspired by me, follow me on my business page. Follow me on my personal wall. The third post is a post where I ask for someone else to host a class. And that if the hostess actually gets 3 of her friends to host a class, she gets a gift. I have found that women are more likely to agree to host something if they know that their friend is going to benefit from it. And so if 3 women from one class agree to host, that hostess gets a gift, okay? And then finally, the very last post is a video about joining the opportunity. And it's just a very real, raw, these are the hesitations I had about the business, and here's what I found. I talk about the fact that I didn't have time, that I didn't know anything about the products, that I didn't know anything about sales or social media, and just how I overcame those things, and that I am confident enough that I can teach them to do the same thing, okay? And so that is the final closing video of the class. I make sure that they know the link is still open for 5 more days. I give them the date. I message the hostess the day before her link closes just to remind her, hey, your link closes tomorrow. Make sure you message your friends. Make sure you post in your class that they only have tomorrow to order, okay? So it keeps me in connection with my hostess, which is fabulous. And like I said, I run a lot of parties at one time, so I can't go live in all of my parties, but I definitely think you can incorporate lives into your parties, and I think it's fabulous. So I just like was a fire hydrant all over you. Hopefully that was helpful, okay? Here's what you have to remember, okay? Here's what you have to remember. My success is not because of this script. My guess is a whole bunch of you are gonna come up with a script that blows mine out of the water. It's not the script. That is not the secret. The secret is consistency. The secret is hustling. I never stop. I've run 1,026 parties, and it's not because I have this amazing script. It's because I don't quit. It's because I ask every day. It's because I think I am offering something fabulous. I never look at it as someone doing a favor for me, but me doing something that's going to bring value to their life. Okay? So don't overthink this. It does not have to be what I just told you. Okay? I do think that if you go at it from the angle of solving people's problems, you're going to have better results. But remember, 551 of mine qualified, and that accounts for some of my own. So more than half of my parties don't qualify. The percentage of those that are actually zero sales is probably pretty high. You will only fail at this if you fail to expand your network through each one. That is why I do this. That is why I do these parties, because I am in network marketing. And in network marketing, you expand your network. And this is the way that I have found to expand my network through social media and feel proud of it, feel good about the relationships that I'm making, and still be able to not go crazy by having to leave my house to do it. Okay? Now, here's some things I just want to caution you with, okay, as we finish up here. Number one, no, I will not add you to any of my parties. I'm sure I've already gotten messages. There are over 1,000 people watching right now, okay? On average, I get 10% of return in messages from my trainings. So no, I cannot add you to my parties. Please do not be sneaky. Please do not make fake accounts. Please do not lie to me. Okay. If you are not with my company and you would like to host one with me, that is fabulous. But I cannot host these classes for people within my company. Okay. Nor can I add you to any of the groups. Don't overthink it. Don't try to be me. Okay. You be you. What were the problems you had before you started using the products? How did the product solve those problems for you? Then go show people how that happened, okay? I know that you probably have a ton of detailed nitty-gritty questions, because you always do, people always do, right? Like, where is the link and what day do you? Okay, let me just caution you, okay? Don't worry about those things. Just keep it simple. Just do, all right? Rather than allowing yourself to be paralyzed by the small nitty-gritty questions like, where should I put the link, or what day should I do this, or when should the hostess do this, just do it. Don't worry about it. You're gonna screw up. You're gonna fail. Some things are not going to work. I didn't get to where I am without failing over and over and over and over again, okay? You're not going to find success unless you have failures. So if you try to get around your failures by asking 3,000 questions before you actually start, you're never going to start and you're never going to find success. My most successful team members are the ones that don't ask me 3,000 questions. And that's not me saying I'm irritated by questions. That's not it at all. What I'm saying is my most successful team members are the ones that just do it. And they learn what works for them along the way. Because the reality is, I could tell you every single little thing that I do, and it may not work the best for you. Okay? You have to figure it out. I've given you the game plan. Now go do it. Go do it. You can do this. And when we all get better at this, we will all be better. All right. I'm not even going to take any questions. Okay? Because I want you to just listen to what I shared and then go do it. Go do it. Change it. Tweak it. Make it your own. Be proud of what you have and be confident in that you have something to offer the world. Okay? Deal? All right. Now, as always, feel free to share this video. It's public. Share it to your team members. Share it wherever you would like. It's yours. Take it. All right? Have fun. Be successful. Go fail. All right. Thank you so much. Thanks for tuning in. Again, my name is Kara Lewis Newton. Feel free to share this video. I will do my best to answer as many messages as I can. If it takes me a little while in getting back to you, obviously you know why. But thank you so much. Have a fabulous day.